Good morning, everyone. I'm Dr. Apoorva Reddy Davu from Medicity Institute of Medical Sciences, Mechil. I'm going to present a rare case of lateral lumbar meningocele in a patient with neurofibromatosis. The objective is to present a rare case of lateral lumbar meningocele and establish imaging features. Introduction: a meningocele is a saccular protrusion of meninges through the intervertebral foramina or eroded vertebrae. Lumbar meningoceles are part of the complex manifestation of neurofibromatosis. Although osseous abnormalities are one of the 7 diagnostic criteria for NF1, neurofibromatosis type 1 consists of most prevalent phycomatosis, which are neurocutaneous syndromes of neural crest origin with low emphasis on osseous abnormalities. Meningeal protrusions most commonly occur in the thoracic region, but they can also develop in cervical, lumbar, or sacral regions. In this case, a lateral lumbar meningocele was discovered, which is rare in the literature. Case history: it was a 45-year-old female who presented with chronic lower back pain. The pain was not associated with postural alteration of the truncus. Neurological examination revealed no deficit. Bladder and bowel functions were normal. On clinical examination, there was widespread cephalate spots, cutaneous neurofibromas, and reddish brown spots on the iris were noted, consistent with diagnosis of neurofibromatosis. Here we can see widely spread cephalate spots. Imaging features: on abdominal ultrasound, a large cyst was noted in the retroperitoneum that was interpreted as the right pararenal cyst. CECT confirmed the presence of retroperitoneal cystic lesion displacing the right kidney superiorly. The lesion was extending into the right neural foramina of L3 and L4 vertebrae into the spinal canal. Diagnosis of lateral lumbar meningocele was made. MRI confirmed the above findings and the lesion was described as a well-defined, large, lobulated CSF intense areas extending from the spinal canal at L3 and L4 level through the foraminal region into the right paravertebral region, causing scalloping of vertebral bodies. Few traversing nerve roots were noted inside the lesion. Hence, diagnosis of the lateral lumbar meningocele was confirmed. These are the images of CT plane, arterial phase, and venous phase showing a retroperitoneal cystic lesion displacing the right kidney superiorly. The lesion was extending into the right neural foramina of L3 and L4 vertebrae into the spinal canal. This is an MRI spine scout. Here we can see the meningocele. This is a T1 weighted MRI image, which was described as a well-defined, large, lobulated lesion. This is a spinal sagittal T2 weighted MRI image. Here we can see the meningocele. These are the sagittal T2 stir image and sagittal T2 MR myelography images. Discussion: neurofibromatosis is a congenital and hereditary dysplasia that is inherited as an autosomal dominant trait. It involves mesodermal and neuroectodermal tissues with manifestations in the central nervous system and musculoskeletal system. Skeletal manifestations include vertebral dysplasia with kyphoscoliosis, spinal cord lesions, extradural masses, erosions of intervertebral foramina due to the dumbbell neurofibromas, dural ectasia, and lateral meningoceles. Meningoceles in neurofibromatosis are commonly associated with dural ectasia and herniation of the theca sacs through a defect in the lateral aspect of the vertebrae or through the widened intervertebral foramina, and when present are usually intrathoracic. The rarity of this reported case is due to the location and size of the meningocele. Conclusion: in this particular case, we report the imaging features of uncommon spinal manifestations of neurofibromatosis and also including the widening of intervertebral foramina due to lateral meningocele. These are the references. Thank you.